So I hung the template for my freestanding range hood. Right here I made a level line for the height of the hood, and then the template was a sheet of paper. I basically lined it up perfectly on that line and I put some tape on it. Then it gives you the pilot holes of exactly where to put the pilots. Of course, where I needed a stud, there wasn't any studs. So I used the plastic anchors in there. They're all about 3/8 of an inch, and I put my bolts in there as well. Now I'm going to cut the 6-inch vent hole that's going to go outside to vent all the cooking fumes and whatnot. And of course, there's a stud directly in the middle. Where I don't want a stud, there's a stud. Where I needed a stud, there isn't a stud. Welcome to construction. So, I got my drill hooked up with the chuck. Again, 6-inch hole. We got to do a 6-inch vent pipe coming from the top of the hood to be exhausted outside. So this should go through it. I'm gonna put it on the reverse as first. If you keep it on the way it's supposed to spin, the teeth kind of grab in and it keeps like locking and makes it harder. So I actually put the blade on reverse and make that cut. So let's see how it's gonna go. And there's always a screw. Insulation there, and of course, like I said, the stud's right there, so you can see it. So I'm gonna keep going through and hope for the best. Exterior sheathing right now. I'm only about a halfway through that stud. There's a nail in my way that I was getting hung up on, of course. So let me pull that and keep going. Alright, I reached the sheathing, so I'm going to try to go a little bit further, but I want to see exactly where in the exterior of my house the pilot hole is going to come through. There's nothing in the way, but I want to finish off the cut from the outside in, just so it's clean, it's not going to cut up the vinyl siding out there. Daylight, so I'm gonna move this operation to outside and I'll finish the cut from the outside in. So it's very important when you cut vinyl siding that you put your drill in the reverse. The teeth on this bit are very jagged. If you go in the forward motion, you're gonna grab the vinyl siding, tear it apart, and rip it. If you spin it in reverse, there's still enough cut in that blade that's gonna make a nice smooth cut in the siding. So I'm gonna line up my pilot hole with the hole I got in there, spin it in reverse, and I'll cut right through. All right, the siding's cut through now. Pull it out. A little bit of insulation, and then I should be right through the sheathing. So at this point, I'm gonna do a little bit more with the reverse, and then I'll flip the switch and dig into the sheathing. Looks like there's also cedar siding, which I don't know why you would ever put vinyl siding over cedar, but it looks beautiful too. That's unfortunate. All right, I'm gonna put the drill bit on a dig now. We are through. Got a nice 6-inch hole. Good to go. All right, so I slid the vent in from the outside in. I'm just trying to template to see how much ducting I need and where I'm gonna be at exactly. So I measured the top of my vent hood is gonna be right at these bolts right there. And 3.5 inches up, that's the top of the stack off the vent. So I'm gonna be right about here. That's where I need my vent to be to make that connection. So I got a 90 degree elbow. Put that in there. I'm still about 2 inches short. I have this connector right here. That slides in. And I might be a little bit long. Now this isn't gonna go inside the actual vent. I'm gonna have to cut this part off. So this actually slides over the vent stack. So that was my line. I'm well past that. Again, I'll cut right here. That should slide over the vent stack and I'll be golden. I'll put a couple of metal screws in there. I'll tape it with ducting tape and I'll be good. So I secured the vent to these two anchors in the back. It just kind of goes and slides down. There's also two under here that I had already pre-drilled. So I'm gonna screw these in, these long bolts. Put the old level on it, see where we're at. Okay, the side gotta go up a little bit over here. Actually perfect right there. I'm gonna tighten up the bolts now and it should be locked in place. All right, now like I said before, so the electrical, put that to the side. I'm gonna put this back in there and try to figure out exactly where I need to cut here so it'll be perfect. Right about there is good. All right, I don't need much. Yeah, like 2.5 inches will work for that. 3 is too much. We'll go with 2.5. All right, so the vent hood secured. I attached the 6-inch vent pipe. I screwed on the vent from outside into the siding. We got our 90-degree, and then I had a little extension in there too. So I used the flex tape on the bottom and the top, sealed it all up. Now I got my power right here. So I'm gonna hook up the power real quick, put wire nuts, tape that off and secure that. Then I have to put a little bracket on top and that will hold the actual chimney part of it. And then that should be it. So let's see how this goes. So I found the center point again. Put a little X there. This bracket's gonna hold the chute on. There's a couple of holes on both sides. All right, so we're all good to go here. This is the chimney. This laser film took like 5 minutes to take off of this stuff. It's insane. But that's about it. There's two slides. You can go higher up if need be. So I'll put it all at the bottom and slide it through. Gonna slide up and then I'm just gonna put two little screws on both sides to lock that in place, and that's basically it. I'll peel this off, stove back, good to go.